Having completed the coding of card type, now it is time to update and configure the account form template to accommodate the account type information. So we are back in the accountform.html, and first we will start putting a OE block validator to accommodate the account type information block. So this is the place where we will be instantiating the card type element. So you could observe that we have set up a heading, so which prints that select the type of savings account you want. And then we are setting up a iron selector. So this is where you are data binding with a type of account here. And also observe that we are setting up a DOM repeat here, and this will get all the current instances of the account types, and that will get populated as part of this items here. And as a result of that, for each of this item, you are instantiating a copy of the card type element that we are declared here, and you could observe that the card will contain the instance that is present in the item here. And you are printing item code as a title here, and then you are checking whether this is checked or not. So for that, you are calling this function called underscore is selected. So that is how we are setting up this card type. And we will discuss the code that is associated with the underscore is selected with these two parameters of item code and type of account in a short while from now. The next thing that we need to figure out is how is this type of account getting populated here, or how is this account types is actually getting the list of the current account types. In order to do that, first let's include a property here which is known as the ACC types. And if you could see that this ACC types is nothing but the property of this element which is getting data bound as part of the declaration section of the element. So in the markup we have an ACC types which is equated into this items here, and that is what is actually getting data bind as part of this ACC types. The next thing that we need to figure out is how do we get the instance values. Currently there are three instance values for the accounts, and how do we get these values and then get populated into the account types. So it is in this context we will have to code our next method, which is a lifecycle method called created. So let's do that. Before we code the lifecycle method called created, there is one more little thing that we need to do, which is including certain behaviors which are given by the OE cloud. So let us try and understand what these behaviors are. So we have listed several behaviors as part of this behaviors array, which is form validation behavior, model behavior, and forms messages behavior, and Ajax behavior. I will have more to say about these things in the next sections, but the right now what we are concerned is with this Ajax behavior. So let us see where this is located. So if you just go to this client folder and then take a look at behaviors, you have this Ajax behavior which is available here, and this is an element, and this script is making use of a global variable which is base utils, and that's what is getting exported. And in this for this Ajax behavior, so there is a method called make Ajax call which is available, and so therefore this utility is actually coded here. So now the idea is we make a call to this particular method called function called make Ajax call in order to be able to talk to any of the standard APIs where we need to be requesting for some data from the APIs. So let's do that. So in order to do that, let us include a lifecycle method here, which is created. And so what essentially this is doing is, it is when this element of account form is getting created, it will call this lifecycle method called created, and that is when it is actually making a call to this particular account types, which is in the available in the API URL, and this is where we are making the AJAX call, and we are getting the response, and whatever is there in the response, which is essentially the account types, that is what we are actually giving this to this dot ACC types here. So therefore, this ACC types is getting its list of or the array of account types from this response right at the time of this element creation. So that is how you are having all this data ready at the time of this creation of this. So in nutshell, the created callback function is going to set this account types right at the time of element creation, and this ACC types is data bound here, and so therefore it is getting the list of the current instances into this items array, and then this is the place using a DOM repeat. You are essentially instantiating three elements of the cart type, and for which each of these item is being passed as the parameter or the ID, and therefore it is getting rendered here. So that's exactly what is happening in this block of code. And now we will proceed to this function called underscore is selected, and code this one. So to do that, we are going to need another property called a type of account, and initially this is containing the value called the savings plus. So let's keep this in mind. Now let's move on to the creation of underscore is selected. So you could observe that we have the code of underscore is selected, which is a function that is accepting two parameters. One is account title, second is the selected account. And so therefore, if you just look at the function call that is happening over here, for each item code, for each item that is getting selected here, it is actually comparing this item code with the type of account. Recall from our element that the type of account is initially having the savings plus value. So for every item that is getting populated, this function will get called with the savings value as a type of account and then the item code. So with these two parameters, the function is getting called. And inside this function, you could observe that the account title is getting, compared with this account, selected account. Into this, you are actually passing this value that is of the type of account here. And once that comparison is taking place, for the first time, the savings plus account will be checked. And in the subsequent selections, if the user chooses another one, and because this is data bound, the value will flow from the markup to the element. So because this is you could see that this type of account is data bound here, so in case the user makes a change here of the selection, then the value will be collected here, and that is what will flow down to the type of account property from the DOM to the model. The next thing that we are going to do is we are going to need another property here, so which is the preferred branch that should be selected. So let's put this here.